On a dark night, away from city lights, you can see constellations in the sky, like Orion. But if it's dark enough, you can also see a pale white band, the Milky Way. But what is that band? We can find the answer if we leave Earth, flying into space at billions of times the speed of light. We see the Milky Way in our night sky because our solar system is in a gigantic disk of billions and billions of other stars, the Milky Way galaxy. When we look out at right angles to our galaxy's disk, we see relatively few stars. But if we look through the disk, we see many more, though in some areas they are obscured by dust. That view through our galaxy's stellar disk is what we see as the Milky Way. Our home galaxy is 100,000 light-years across, but only 1,000 light-years thick. If we look face-on, we can see interesting structures. Spiral arms, where blue, young stars are more common, and darker lanes made of interstellar dust. It has taken the Milky Way 13 billion years to grow to its present size, with 300 billion stars. Our galaxy has grown by attracting and absorbing smaller galaxies. In fact, our galaxy is ingesting a dwarf galaxy right now. This is the Sagittarius Stream, the remnant of a dwarf galaxy that collided with our own 5 billion years ago. In a few billion years, no visible trace of this dwarf galaxy will remain, as its stars mingle with the outskirts of the Milky Way. But our galaxy does not destroy all of the dwarf galaxies that come its way. Some end up orbiting us. Here, for instance, are the large and small Magellanic Clouds, some of the nearest galaxies to our own. From the southern hemisphere, you can see these dwarf galaxies as small, cloud-like patches in the sky. So remember, the next time you view that hazy band of stars on a dark night, it shows you how we are part of a large disk of billions of stars, 100,000 light-years across.